हेलो
हेलो हेलो कैन एवरी
हेलो
हेलो हेलो हेलो गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू? हेलो 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 गुड इवनिंग एवरी वन। सो माई सेल्फ नेहा सोनकर पाठक, आई एम वाइस प्रिंसिपल ऑफ पेनिया ऋषिकेश स्कूल फ्रॉम धनबाद। सो टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज साइबर सेफ्टी एंड सिक्योरिटी। सो वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस। सो फर्स्ट, बिफोर नोइंग दिस, व्हाट इज साइबर? साइबर इज बेसिकली एन इंटरनेट वर्ल्ड वेयर वी नीड एन इंटरनेट प्रोटेक्शन। ओके, सो बिफोर दैट, इन देयर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन सेफ्टी एंड सिक्योरिटी। देयर इज अ स्लाइट डिफरेंस इन सेफ्टी एंड सिक्योरिटी। लाइक सेफ्टी, वी फोकस ऑन प्रिवेंटिंग एक्सीडेंट्स, वी टेक द प्रिकॉशन बिफोर हैंड। लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ यू थिंक देयर इज एन फायर गोइंग टू बी टेकिंग प्लेस, सो वॉट वुड यू डू? यू विल बी पुटिंग योर फायर एक्सटिंग्विशर एंड ऑल द इक्विपमेंट्स विच आर नेसेसरी टू पुट ऑफ द फायर। So we are taking the precautions beforehand, we are taking the safety beforehand. And security, you don't know whether that accident is going to occur or not, but you are before that you are taking some precautions. Okay, but the both has the aim to protect the assets and safety addresses unintentional risks, while security addresses deliberate threats. So here, safety and security, first before we have to understand that what is in safety and security of the cyber world. Now, if anybody enters your house without your knowledge, okay, and you would not like that. In the same way, if anybody enters your internet world, your Facebook, your Instagram, without your knowledge, they hack your profile and they give various comments and they make a fake profile of it and they tell other relatives, they try to contact your other relatives. So in that, what would you do? You would like to protect your internet, you would like to protect your Facebook account and everything. In that place, what we do, we actually use antivirus where we can protect our mobile phones from this before hacking, that no cookies appear there, nobody is able to hack your profiles. So in that case, so cyberspace, when we talk about the cyberspace is a space where your internet world is being protected. Without your permission, nobody is allowed to enter your personal IDs, like Facebook IDs, like or Instagram. Am I clear with this point? Thank you. Now, cyber safety and security, the main focus of the cyber safety and security. Cyber safety, it basically focuses on promoting responsible online awareness among individuals and communities. And cyber security, they focus on protecting digital systems, networks, data from cyber threats. Okay, the main focus of the cyber safety is to protect our community and protect the awareness among our individual and communities. And whereas in cyber security, we focus on protecting our digital systems, network data, that our data do not leak. Our passwords doesn't leak while we are using our net banking, that our passwords are being protected. Now, what is the goal of the cyber safety and security? Now, the cyber safety, they aim to create safe and positive online experience by reducing risk and promoting ethical behavior. And whereas cyber security aims to safeguard digital assets and maintain the confidentiality, integrity, and integrity of information and systems. This is what all about is cyber safety and security. Now, cyber ethics. What is cyber ethics? When there's a permission, whenever we go to anybody's place, we first ask for permission, whether we can enter their house or not. In the same sense, there's a cyber ethics also, where it is the involvement of computers. If anybody is touching your computer or taking your, or using a mobile phone, they need to have your permission first. Okay, if anybody is sending you Facebook, in Facebook, they are sending your request. If anybody is sending in Facebook friend request, in that also they need their permission. Without your permission, they cannot be added automatically. Okay, so in that case, cyber ethics means permission, where in the cyber world, if anybody is wanting to have a friendship with you or is want to see your personal information or something, they need to have your permissions. Now, cyber ethics is the philosophic study of ethics pertaining to computers, encompassing using behavior and what computers are programmed to do and how this affects individuals and society. It is a set of legal or moral values or a code of responsible behavior applied to the online environment. In simple as that, साइबर एथिक्स वेयर योर बिहेवियर वेयर द डिफरेंट पीपल आर कमिंग इन कॉन्टैक्ट थ्रू द इंटरनेट व्हाट इज देयर बिहेवियर पैटर्न ओके हाउ दे इफेक्ट individual as well as the society there are some legal and moral values before they come to contact in an online world now ethical issues what are the ethical issues that is intellectual property rights plagiarism digital property rights so here whatever is important in our school we'll be talking about that only So intellectual property rights are the rights of the owner of information to decide how much information exchange, shared or distributed. This is totally depends on the person, whoever is using. Okay, whatever you're using in the internet world, this is your right, how much you want to restrict, that how much information should the person should be knowing about you and how much it should be shared and how much it should be distributed. It depends on the individual person who wants to share their personal information. Now, images. Are photos intellectual property rights? Images and photos are items of intellectual property. Thus, the photograph is automatically regarded as the owner of the images. If he or she is not present in the photographic under copyright law, the owner of a photograph has an exclusive right to that photograph. Am I audible to you? So here the property rights, when we talk about the photos. Photos, if you want the photos to be shared, like if, for instance, if any of your friend has taken a photo of yours, okay? And it without your permission, your friend cannot post the photo until and unless your permission is there. And if without your knowledge, if the photos has been posted, under the copyright law, you can file a case on that person. And same vice versa with the people, with you also, if you are without knowledge, you are presenting the photo in the internet world without the knowledge of the other person, then it is totally wrong. The permission is needed before the images or photo is being shared. What can you do if someone posts your picture without your permission? Well, we have already spoken about it. Although talking about a photo of you in public setting is not an invasion of privacy. If the person captures you in your home and then uses it on social media without your consent, you have a legal recourse and attorney may classify this type of action defamation as well. If the photo has been taken in a public place, then your permission has been not needed. If the photo has been taken in a private place in your home, and without your consent, the photo has been posted, then you can file a case on the other person. Am I clear with this? So we move on to next, then intellectual property rights included. Then there is a patent, copyright, industrial design rights, trademarks, graphical indications, layout design, and jurisdiction trade secrets. When we talk about patent, patent is basically a form of intellectual property rights, give its owner the legal right to exclude others from making, using, selling, and importing an invention for a limited period of years. In exchange for publishing and enabling public disclosure of the invention. Patent, when we are having a right, okay, like for LG, like LG has produced a refrigerator, okay, the LG has manufactured the refrigerator, and if you want to do the refrigerator, if you want to resell the refrigerator by assembling it, and you want to put the logo of an LG without their knowledge, okay, then it is wrong. They can hello. So here the patent. In simple language, जब आप किसी जैसे कोई फ्रिज है, ठीक है, एलजी का आपने फ्रिज लिया, एलजी का एक पेटेंट है कि फ्रिज का पेटेंट है एलजी का लोगो एलजी, ठीक है, और आपको लगता है कि आप उसको, आप फ्रिज को असेंबल करके आप भी उस चीज का बिजनेस कर सकते हो, और आपको आप नया प्रोडक्ट है आपका वो अभी मार्केट पे, एंड यू कैनॉट सेल इट. Okay, so what you do by without the knowledge of the LG, you put that logo. Okay, in that case, if the LG comes to know about it, they can file a case on. Simple as that. So patent is a right. If any the company takes it, and company takes it, okay, with for their patent. जहां पर मतलब पेटेंट है कि वो अपने कंपनी को अपना अपना लोगो रिस्ट्रिक्ट कर लिए, वो तब तक नहीं देते हैं अनलेस एंड अंटिल यू टेक द फ्रेंचाइजी ऑफ इट. सिंपल एज दैट. नाउ ऑल राइट्स रिजर्व. कॉपीराइट. कॉपीराइट बेसिकली इट इज रिलेटेड टू द क्रिएटिव वर्क. ओके, नाउ क्रिएटिव वर्क, अगर आपने जैसे हम लोग बुक लिखे, मतलब जैसे आपने इंग्लिश का एक बुक लिखा, एंड इफ यू वांट दैट उसका जो राइट है वो आपके पास रहे, वहां पर आप एक एप्लीकेशन दे सकते हो, एंड कॉपीराइट दैट दिस कॉपी बिलोंग्स टू यू, एंड योर दिस क्रिएटिव वर्क कैन नॉट बी टेकन अवे. ओके, जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल चेतन भगत बुक विदाउट हिज नॉलेज, थ्री इडियट्स हैव बीन मेड. ओके, ऑल द कंटेंट हैज बीन टेकन फ्रॉम देयर. सो इन दैट केस व्हाट डिड चेतन भगत डू, बिकॉज दैट वाज अ क्रिएटिव वर्क, ही हैज ऑलरेडी टेकन द कॉपीराइट ऑफ इट. इन दैट केस चेतन भगत फाइल्ड अ केस अगेंस्ट द प्रोड्यूसर, बिकॉज विदाउट हिज नॉलेज, विदाउट पेइंग द रॉयल्टी, हिज क्रिएटिव वर्क हैज बीन स्टोलन. Okay, so in that case, the copyright is being given. The right is been reserved for the creative work. No, without your knowledge, nobody can steal it. Now, if you want to register for the copyright, so these are the steps to register a book or the other creative work. Simply go to copyright.gov. There is an online portal to register copyrights for photographs, sculptures, and written works, and fill out the form and pay the fee, and you are registered. Simple as that. You have to go to the copyright.gov, and you have to register your copyrights. You have to give the photographs of the creative work what you have written. You have to put the sculptures. You have to give the written works. You have to write the fill the form. You have to pay the fee, and you are registered. And your book has been, your creative work has been registered. Now, can Google determine copyright? No. When we receive a complete and valid notice, we remove the content as the law requires. Here what they are trying to say, like without the knowledge of anyone, you have copied a music, okay, and you have made a reel of it, and you have put on the Facebook or the Google forum, There, what they can do, if the Google, if anybody complains against you in the Google tells you to remove the content then and there. Okay, so you have to remove it. Now, trademark. What is trademark? Basically, when you are doing an interstate business or you are doing an import and export business, there you need to have a trademark where your products can be recognized. Now, when you can use the TM symbol. The TM symbol is used for common law marks that represent goods or services that are not federally registered with the USPTO, including marks whose registration is pending. The TM symbol and the word trademark is interpreted as broadly covering both product marks and service marks. Now, what is plagiarism? Now, plagiarism is simple as that, stealing of someone else's intellectual work as its own work without seeking the source of information. Plagiarism is simple word is stealing. You are stealing someone's work without reason or knowledge. Digital copyrights, it includes data, internet accounts, and other rights including intellectual rights and intellectual property rights, such as pictures, music, movies, literary works, web pages, computer code, and other creative works. So this is what digital property right is. Now, authorization and authentication. Authentication means confirming your own identity. Authorization means granting access to the system, like authentication. When you are in the airport or in any government place, when you are showing your identity card or you are showing your Aadhaar card, you are confirming that you are the person. You are authentication. Your own identification is being confirmed. Whereas authorization, you are giving a permission that on your behalf, the other actions can be taken place. For example, you have a joint account. Okay. In that, you are giving the authorization to your second joint member that in your behalf, he or she can sign the check. That you are giving the authorization. Now on the next topic, that is security breach, cyber attack, hacking, and phishing. Cyber attack. Cyber attack is an attempt to disable computers, steal data, or use a breached computer system to launch additional attacks. Cybercrime use different methods to launch a cyber attack that includes malware, phishing, ransomware, man-in-the-middle attack, or other methods. Now, cyber attack, where the cyber attack has been taking place, like on the Facebook, especially this has been very common nowadays, that your profile has been hacked and another profile of your name is being made. Okay, and there they are demanding a money from your relatives, from your friends on your behalf. This is what the cyber attack. Your account has been hacked, your data has been stolen. That is what this cyber attack all about. Now, hacking. Hacking. Hacking refers to the misuse of devices like computers, smartphones, tablets, network to cause a damage to or corrupt systems, gather information on users, steal data and documents, or disrupt data related activity. Like your phone has been hacked, your computer has been hacked, and all the informations are being stolen from them. Sometimes what happens when we are using internet banking, when we use the internet banking, we do not log out because we think we will forget our passwords. In that case, what happens if anybody is tracking your phone, they can take the information of it and they can use your internet banking and then they can store your money. So whenever you are using your internet banking, you should be logging out after using it. Now, phishing. Phishing, there's a two type of phishing. F-I-S-H-I-N-G. Phishing, where you are trying to catch the fishes. Now here in the phishing, P-H-I-S-H-I-N-G, in the internet world, where the hackers are looking for the people whom they can trick, whom they can hack, whose software they can hack, whose data they can steal. That is what is hack, that is phishing. Phishing is a type, of social engineering where an attacker send in fraudulent examples, spoof, fake or otherwise deceptive message designed to trick a person into revealing sensitive information to the attackers or to deploy malicious software on the victim's infrastructure like ransomware. Phishing attacks have become increasingly sophisticated and often transparently mirrored the site being targeted, allowing the attackers to absorb everything while the victim is navigating the site and transverse any additional security boundaries with the victim. As of 2020, phishing is by far the most common attack performed by the cyber criminals. Now, phishing has been different types of phishing, where earlier the email has been sent where you have won the US lottery of 1 crore, 1 billion crore. You see this type of messages we get, this type of mails we get in our email. Sometimes in our greed or in our curiosity, we try to open that link. And when we think that we are going to, without any investment, we are going to have this money, where what we do? We fill off all the things. Okay, and there we think we'll be getting the money, but the hackers have thrown the net to just to attack us, to get caught of us. Now, child pornography. Child pornography, now referred as a C-scam, child sexual abuse material, features of an online predator, SOS procedure for a victim, role of parents to combat predators. Now, child pornography has become very normal nowadays. Why? Because now the child has been addicted with the phone too much. Now, what they do when, because they do not get the time of their parents, or they find an emotional bonding in the Facebook or Instagram, they don't know what type of an hackers they are being trapped by. Okay, they're emotionally, they have been misused, they have been abused, and there they are being told that if you child pornography has been taken place. इंटरनेट सेफ्टी रूल्स, इंटरनेट सेफ्टी रूल्स, व्हाट टू डू ऑनलाइन, व्हेन एवर यू आर गोइंग ऑनलाइन व्हाट यू शुड बी डूइंग, सॉरी व्हाट व्हाट नॉट टू डू ऑनलाइन, की पर्सनल इंफॉर्मेशन प्रोफेशनल एंड लिमिटेड, यू थिंक दैट द पर्सन इज ट्रस्टवर्दी, हाउ मच योर इंफॉर्मेशन शुड बी शेयर्ड, दैट टोटली डिपेंड्स अपॉन यू, and you should be sharing the personal information that much only. Keep your privacy settings on. If you keep your privacy settings on, then obviously whenever whenever marketers love to know all about you, both can learn a lot them from your browsing and social media. This also we have an habit. Whenever we use our Facebook or Instagram or any other online platform, we do not log out. Okay, there what happens? Our information is been extracted. In that case, our privacy setting should be always on, that nobody hacks our online platform accounts. Practice safe browsing. You should be practicing the safe browsing, whatever if you think that this browsing site is fine and no cookies appear, then you should be using that browsing site. Your internet connection is, make sure your internet connection is secure. Whatever internet you are using, it should be secure. Try not to use free Wi-Fi if it is given in the railways or in a bus stands or in the public place where the free internet is being given to you. Do not use that, because in that the information is been attracted by the hackers from your phone. That's why free internet is been given. There is a lot of scam on it. So before using free Wi-Fi or free internet, please do be careful while using it. Be careful what you download. Whenever you are downloading anything, you should make sure that the sites, whatever you are downloading, is safe. And if you put your antivirus in your laptop or in your phone, before, if you any malicious site is there, if you are downloading it, they will always show there's a message pops on that this site is not very nice and this site is not very trustworthy, so you should not be downloading it. So before that, whatever you download, if you install antivirus, it will protect your phone and laptops. Passwords. You should have a strong password. First, whenever you are using internet banking, your password should be changed within 3 months, every 3 months. Now, the system has been upgraded. If you are using your SBI, you know SBI, it has been 3 months, they will automatically they will tell you to change your passwords. Okay, like for the Facebook, for your online platforms, whatever you are using, You should be changing your passwords every 3 months, that nobody hacks your password. And your password should be strong. How would you make your password strong? In that case, a caps lock, one caps lock should be there. Your capital letters, it means. Then your one small letter, special characters like dollar S, then your symbols, hash, all these things should be used. At the rate, underscore, do not ever, whenever you are making a password, do not use your birth date, because that is very easy for the hackers to hack it. Be careful who you meet online. There is a trend in the youngsters. What they do to make their friend list or friend, their following too much, whatever friend request they are getting, they add on. In that case, they don't know who is correct or who is the wrong person. They fall in a trap. So in that case, if you don't know the person and they are not from your surroundings, not from where, from your friend circle, from your society, or from your relative sides, do not accept them. And if you think that the person is not, you are feeling very suspicious about that person, you should not add that person unless you know about that person. So be careful whom you are meeting online, whom you are chatting with. Keep your antivirus program up to date. If your antivirus program is up to date, then the threats will be less. Your computers, your mobile phones, these are being protected. So you should be in a day-to-day, you should be updating your antivirus programs. Now, how do people fall in a trap of ransom attack? Ransomware is a type of a malicious software that threatens to publish or blocks access to data or a computer system, usually by encrypting it until the victim pays a ransom fee to the attackers. In many cases, the ransom demand comes with a deadline. If the victim does not pay in the time, the data is gone forever or the ransom increases. So this is how the people fall in a trap of a ransom attack. Introducing dark web online human trafficking. Online shopping. E-commerce platform. Here what happens? In e-commerce, we fall in a trap of a discount. Okay. In the Facebook we go, there we see there's an advertisement like 50% discount or 30% discount. Sometimes we overlook the spelling of the site which we are using, like Myntra or Amazon. Like there are phishing in the spelling, like Myntra, M-N-T-R-A. But the original spelling of Myntra is M-Y-N-T-R-A. Okay. But we fall to see that because we are trapped in the discount thing. Here what happens, you go and purchase online. Okay. You don't see the platform, you don't see the e-commerce platform what you are using. And you online, you pay the money. And after some time, you realize that you have been trapped. You have ordered from the wrong site. And your money is being lost. So before using e-commerce platform, in the other different websites or different sites, please go and see the site what you are using, whether the site is genuine or not. Identity theft, an unfortunate fact of modern life. Like sometimes what happened, when we go to the Xerox machine, Xerox parlor or something, okay, like sometimes we need a Xerox of our PAN card or Aadhaar card. Sometimes we don't know whether anybody is taking our extra copy of it. There is an incident I have come across now. There is a person, मतलब वहां पर क्या हुआ कि वो जो बैंक में उन्होंने बैंक का कोई लोन नहीं लिया था, वहां पर उनका आईडी प्रूफ किसी ने उसका जीरोक्स ऑलरेडी रखा हुआ था. उस पर्सन ने जाके क्या किया, वहां पर आईसीआईसीआई बैंक में उनके नाम पे लोन ले लिया. और वहां उनका जब ईएमआई स्टार्ट हुआ, उनको पता ही नहीं था कि उनके नाम पे ऑलरेडी फ्रॉड करके किसी ने उनके नाम पे लोन ले लिया है. वहां पर
Am I audible to everyone? Am I audible to everyone? Okay, thank you. So here what happened? The person has been trapped without his knowledge. वहां पर उनके नाम से already loan ले लिया गया. So whenever then you are going to block parlor, वहां पर obviously see that nobody takes extra copy of your identity proof. Okay, so please take a note of it. Now, digital payment infrastructure, online payment fraud, financial fraud. Here also, I would like to share. यहाँ पर क्या हुआ था कि एक person मतलब कहीं पर shift कर रहे थे, ये मतलब उसका transfer होने वाला था. वहाँ पर उन्होंने मतलब फटाफट उन्होंने फर्नीचर इन्वेस्ट किया और वो बेचना चाहते थे. ठीक है, वहां पर मतलब वो इतना मतलब हैजल में थे कि उन्होंने देखा नहीं, वो सीधा जो बायर था वो बोले कि आपको मैं लिंक सेंड करता हूँ और उस लिंक पे आप क्लिक कीजिए, वहां पर आपको मेरा आईडी प्रूफ सब कुछ दिख जाएगा एंड वहां पर हम आपको पेमेंट 50% कर देते हैं. वो पर्सन वहां पर जब वहां लिंक पे वो सेशन पे लिंक जब उन्होंने क्लिक किया, वहां उन्होंने देखा कि उनके अकाउंट से पैसा डेबिट हो गया. दिस टाइप ऑफ ऑनलाइन पेमेंट फ्रॉड ये होना स्टार्ट हो चुका है. व्हेनेवर आप जब भी किसी को पेमेंट करते हो या किसी से आपको पेमेंट मिलने वाला है, प्लीज वहां पर उस लिंक में अगर कोई भी अननोन आपको लिंक भेजे, प्लीज डू नॉट क्लिक ऑन इट. प्लीज टेल देम कि अगर आपको ऑनलाइन पेमेंट लेना है तो वहां पर आप सीधा यूपीआई आईडी का इस्तेमाल करें. ओके, दैट वहां पर आपको जब आप गूगल पे या आप पेटीएम जब यूज कर रहे हो, वहां पर आपको वो दिख जाएगा, वहां पर उनका नाम दिख जाएगा. तो वहां पर क्या होगा कि दैट इज दैट पेमेंट जब आप जिसको ट्रांसफर किए हो वहां पर जेन्युइनली वो दिखेगा एंड नोबडी कैन मेक फूल ऑफ यू. और जैसे अगर कभी भी डेबिट कार्ड का कोई आपका फोर नंबर, लास्ट का फोर नंबर या थ्री नंबर, सीवीवी नंबर जो आपके डेबिट कार्ड या क्रेडिट कार्ड के पीछे जो रहता है, उसको कभी भी किसी के साथ कभी भी शेयर ना करें. वो क्या होता है, उस पर्सन को एक्सेस मिल जाता है कि वो आपके विदाउट नॉलेज वो आपका डेबिट कार्ड क्रेडिट कार्ड विदाउट उनके पास रहे हुए भी उसको इस्तेमाल कर सके. तो अगर कभी भी कोई फोन कॉल आता है इफ एनीबडी से सेइंग दैट द पर्सन इज बीन फ्रॉम द बैंक और समथिंग, नो बैंक आस्क योर सीवीवी नंबर. ओके, सो नेवर नेवर एवर यूज योर सीवीवी नंबर. सोशल मीडिया एंड फेक न्यूज, ऑलवेज बी अवेयर ऑफ द सोशल मीडिया एंड फेक न्यूज. इफ देयर एनी फेक न्यूज, इफ यू आर नॉट वेरी श्योर अबाउट द न्यूज, लाइक इट हैपेंस इन द व्हाट्सएप, द न्यूज आर बीइंग वायरल. ओके, विदाउट सीइंग दैट, विदाउट रीडिंग दैट, व्हाटएवर व्हाट वी डू, वी जस्ट फॉरवर्ड टू आवर अदर फ्रेंड्स एंड रिलेटिव्स. सो बिफोर डूइंग दैट, ऑलवेज टेक केयर ऑफ इट. That if you are not sure with the news, please do not share to or forward to the other friends or relatives of yours. Online class safety measures, cyber ethics. Online classroom rules, cyber bullying, cyber ethics, intellectual privacy rights. Before that, I would like to speak about cyber bullying. What happens if persons are being bullied? Here. In the cyber world, the teenagers are being bullied. Not only teenagers, but the other people are also bullied. But here, the main targeted is the teenager. Whatever the teenager has the habit of posting their photos if they go whatever they buy. Sometimes you know the person like loves to bully. वो जब बुली करना चाहते हैं, रॉन्ग कमेंट्स करते हैं, वहां पर वो क्या करते हैं, उसका जितना भी मनोबल है उससे तोड़ने की कोशिश करते हैं. तो वहां पर क्या होता है, साइबर बुलिंग. ये बच्चे जब साइबर बुलिंग के शिकार होते हैं, यहाँ पर वो सुसाइड क्राइम करना या अपने आप को डिप्रेस रखना, दिस वॉट हैपन्स अंडर साइबर बुलिंग. We'll talk about the cyber stalking also. Here it has been not given. Here cyber stalking. जहाँ पर जैसे हम लोग को कोई in person stalk करता है, हमारा पीछा करता है, in the same way in the cyber world we are being stalked. Okay. आपने किसी को without your knowledge, आपने किसी random person को आपने अपने friend list में include कर लिया. एंड वहां पर वो क्या, फ्रेंड लिस्ट में जब आपने इंक्लूड किया, वहां पर वो विदाउट योर नॉलेज वो आपके हर एक हरकत पे वो सीधा नजर रखते हैं और वो आपको स्टॉक करने की कोशिश करते हैं. वो आप कहाँ जा रहे हो, बिकॉज यू आर, आपका लोकेशन ऑन रहता है और वहां पर आप फेसबुक पे एक्टिव हो, इंस्टा में एक्टिव हो, स्नैपशॉट पे एक्टिव हो, जहां पर आपके बारे में सारा इंफॉर्मेशन सबको पता चल रहा है, वहां पर वो आपको स्टॉक कर रहा है. वो स्टॉक करते करते आपसे वो डिमांड करने की कोशिश करता है कि आपके फैमिली मेंबर्स को, किसी को हार्म करने की कोशिश करता है. तो बिफोर कभी भी आप कहीं पर भी जाओ, योर लोकेशन शुड बी ऑफ. ओके, टेक केयर दैट यू शुड ऑलवेज पुट योर लोकेशन ऑफ, दैट नोबडी कीप्स द ट्रैक ऑफ यू. और व्हेनेवर इफ एनीबडी that anybody is trying to stalk you or trying to abuse you in the internet world, then and there unfriend that person. This is what all about cyber ethics, cyber stalking and cyber bullying. Our main motto, that why we are talking about the cyber cyber classes or cyber thing, because the cyber has been increased very much nowadays. This is affecting especially the teenagers. Why the teenagers? Because now the parents have been working here, the communication gap has been come here. They are trying to find their friends and their emotional bonding in the outside world. And they don't know whether that person is right or wrong. They have been trapped in the wrong hand, and they वो शिकार बन जाते हैं साइबर बुलिंग एंड साइबर स्टॉकिंग के। तो ये वॉट एवर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट, आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट यू दैट शेयर विद योर किड्स इन द एट योर होम एज वेल एज विद योर स्टूडेंट्स इन द स्कूल, दैट दिस टाइप ऑफ अ प्रॉब्लम इफ दैट अकर्स, if they are been trapped of the cyber bullying or cyber stalking, they should come and talk to the parents or to the teachers whom they are comfortable with, ki jo unko is problem se nikal sake. So here what we are talking about, we have spoke about that free Wi-Fi should not be used. Our location should be off wherever we are going. So please do keep on mind all these things whenever you are using the internet, or you are prone to, if you are too much, if you want to keep track of your phone phone of your kids or your spouse, or if you want to get a control of everybody's phone, go to the Play Store app, install the app Family Circle. In Family Circle, your other members, the phone of your other members will be connected with it, with your phone, and how much you want that your kid should be using the phone, you can have this locking system in your hand without their knowledge. So this is how you can take a, you can keep a track of your child's phone. So whenever you are using internet, please be careful that how much you must be using to it, and with whom you should be making your friendship. So please do take care of it. So thank you very much, all the patient educators who had been listening to me. Thank you very much.